Hello, today I am going to explain how to derive the stiffness matrix for shafts and shear stress to analyze the shafts. Now here let us go to the finite element formulation of shafts. Now consider a prismatic bar or rod of cross sectional area A and length L, which is applied with a torque of T. When it is applied with the torque T, it will be undergoing a deformation, that is nothing but the shear strain. Now let us consider to analyze the shaft, let us consider the section at AA. Now at AA, if we consider, due to the application of torque, there is angular deformation, that is nothing but the shear strain. Now let the length of the element be dx and deflection here it is taken as d theta and radius of this element is nothing but r. Okay, modulus of rigidity is g. Now you know that in the equilibrium, for the element to be in equilibrium, here in the equation we can write the shear strain into dx is equal to r into d theta, that is why gamma into dx is equal to r into d theta. Now your length varies from 0 to L, because we have taken the length of the bar from 0 length as L. So it is why, that is why it is varies from 0 to L. Similarly, the deflection varies from theta 1 to theta 2. So if we apply this, if we integrate this and apply the limit, we will get the shear strain expression as R by L into theta 2 minus theta 1. Now from the definition of modulus of rigidity, we know that modulus of rigidity is equal to shear stress by shear strain. Now if I just rearrange the equation to get the shear strain stress, that is shear stress is equal to modulus of rigidity into shear strain. Now here from in the equation 1 we got the expression for shear strain. Just substitute the expression for shear strain here. So we get the shear stress expression as g into r by l into theta 2 minus theta 1. Now let us consider this rod as 1D bar element with two nodes. Now here the nodal variables are the angular twists. And here at two nodes, let me consider T1 and T2 with the torques at T1 and 2 respectively. Theta 1 and theta 2 are the twists at node 1 and 2 respectively. And let the length of the element be LE. Now you have the torque equation, that is given by T by J is equal to tau by R. Now we can write the expression T is equal to tau into J by R, where J is the polar moment of inertia. Now if you substitute the value of tau from the expression 3, that is GR by L into theta 2 minus theta 1. Theta 2 minus theta 1, we can represent it as d theta. So if you substitute it, you will get the torque equation T is equal to Gj by L into d theta. Now let us apply the boundary condition. That is, if you see the FEM model, at the node 1, T is equal to T1, theta is equal to theta. And at node 2, T is equal to T2, theta is equal to theta. Now at the node 1, d theta is theta 1 minus theta 2. At the node 2, d theta is equal to theta 2 minus theta 1. So just to apply the boundary condition in the for the equation 5. Now if you apply the boundary condition, so at node 1, T1 is equal to Gj by L into theta 1 minus theta. At the node 2, T is equal to T2 and d theta is equal to theta 2 minus theta 1. That is, T2 is equal to Gj by L into theta 2 minus theta 1. Now these two equations, if you write in the matrix form, we have Gj by L is common and theta 1 and theta 2 are common. Now if I represent in the matrix form, T1 T2 is equal to Gj by L into something into theta 1 by theta 2. Now here in the expression 6, that is for T1, the coefficient of theta 1 is 1, coefficient of theta 2 is minus 1. In the expression 7, that is for T2, theta 1 coefficient is minus 1, theta 2 coefficient is plus 1. So you can write this as Gj by L into 1 minus 1 minus 1 1 into theta 1. That is, g1 is equal to, we write this expression, theta 1 is equal to Gj by L into theta 1 minus theta 2. For t2, if you write, t2 is equal to Gj by L minus theta 1 plus theta 2. Okay. Now, comparing this expression with the equilibrium equation, I can write it as t is equal to a into theta, where t is t1, t2, theta is equal to theta 1, theta 2. So, k is Gj by L into 1 minus 1 minus 1, 1. So, this k is the stiffness matrix for the shaft. Now, let us solve a problem of shaft. So, in this problem, a solid stepped bar of cross-sectional area shown in the figure is subjected to a torque of 1 kN at its free end and torque of 3 kN at its changing cross-section. Determine the angle of twist and shear stress in the bar. Take E is equal to 2 into 10 power 5 Newton per mm square and G is equal to 7 into 10 power 4 Newton per mm square. Now, if you see the figure, there is a change in the cross-section. That means, here we need to go for two elements. That means, three nodes. The first element having length 200, having length 400. First element, diameter is 100 mm. Second element, diameter is 50 mm. Similarly, at node 1, torque is not given. So, that is why T1 is equal to 0. At node 2, it is 3 kN. At node 3, that is 1 kN. So, let me formulate the empty model. Having two elements, length L1 and L2, T1, T2, T3 be the torques at 3 nodes, theta 1, theta 2, theta 3 be the angular twists at the nodes 1, 2 and 3 respectively. Now, you know the diameter, so we can find out J1 and K. Again, L1 and L2 is given. So, stiffness matrix formula for the shaft Gj by L into 1 minus 1 minus 1 1. Now G is given here. J1 we can find out if the diameter of each element is given. Length is also given. So we can get the stiffness matrix for the first element. That is for the first and second node. Similarly, we can find out the stiffness matrix for the element 2, K2, that is for the second and third node. So here also we can find out J and G is given. Length is also given. After finding this element matrix, find out the global stiffness matrix. So, global stiffness matrix K is equal to K1 plus K. So, if you add both the matrices, so you are going to get the global stiffness matrix. Since we have drawn the AFE model for two elements, three nodes, so your global stiffness matrix will be the order of 3 into 3. Now, load vector T is T1, T2, T3, where T1 is not given, 0, T2 is 3, T3 is 1. Okay, now we know the equilibrium equation. Equilibrium equation is T is equal to K into theta, that is K into theta is equal to T. So just substitute the global stiffness matrix, theta is theta 1, theta 2, theta 3. Similarly, we have the values of matrix T. So substitute it and then you apply the boundary conditions. When you apply the boundary conditions, in the figure, the first node is fixed. So, that is why theta 1 is equal to 0. And apply the elimination method of handling boundary conditions. Elimination method of handling boundary conditions wherein we know theta 1 is equal to 0. So, that is why here the row and column corresponding to theta 1 we can eliminate. So, eliminating that the row and column corresponding to theta 1, we will get this matrix. And solve this matrix wherein we have the two unknowns theta 2 and theta 3. So, solving this, we will get the value of theta 2 and theta 3. Now, in the question, it is asked to find out the shear stress. Shear stress formula is, we have derived it as gr by L into theta 1, theta 2. Element 1, it is tau 1 is equal to gr1 by L1 into theta 1, theta 2, theta 1 minus theta 2. And for the element 2, tau 2 is equal to g r2 divided by l2 into theta 2 minus theta 2. So just substitute the corresponding values. For tau 1 it is theta 1 theta 2. For tau 2 it is theta 2 theta 2. So substitute the values and get the values of shear stresses of the element 1 and 2. So this is how we can solve the shaft problems.